guys, this is Randy and Garret here, and today we'll be reviewing Ace Ventura, When Nature Calls. It was the sequel.
I can't find the movie you wanted me to hold it up.
Here.
Oh, yeah. No, this is Pet Detective. You said When Nature Calls it.
Yeah.
But I can't find When Nature Calls it.
It's in my hand.
Oh, you are holding that one. Oh.
It's a sequel to Pet Detective.
It's the sequel to Pet Detective. Ace Ventura. Can everybody see Ace Ventura and his funny hair? Look how funny his hair is.
And it also got...
Where do you think he got in those pants? Look at those crazy pants he wears. I've never seen a pair of pants like that in this store.
It's a movie, Randy. It's a movie. And it also got its own animated series.
That's right. An animated series. He still has funny hair, and he even still has funny pants.
And he even got...
But he's not Jim Carrey anymore. The voice of him is, I don't even know. But he did a pretty good job. He sounds a bit like him.
Okay, so, and you got Ace Ventura Jr., and we don't even have it.
See? We don't have it. Because my hands are empty. Right, Garret?
Yeah? Okay. So, luckily, this movie came after the movie that pretty much everyone hates, Batman Forever.
Batman Forever!
It came, like, right after.
Yeah, that's true, but I don't hate it. I even, well, let's see. You know what? Now that I see all the pictures, I think all the actors in it are pretty much crap, except Jim Carrey.
Jim Carrey was all over the top.
That was the point.
No, but that's not the, that's all Riddler is.
Well, okay, whatever. I didn't hate it.
Yeah, but... It's kind of strange. Jim Carrey doesn't like doing sequels, and yet here he is.
Here he is.
Doing a sequel.
Doing a sequel.
Why are you repeating what I'm saying?
Because you're saying exactly what I was thinking.
Which is also kind of strange, because 1994 was the year, because also Ace Ventura came there, and he also did... Dumb and Dumber. And it got its own sequel.
Like
20 years later.
Yep. And it wasn't very good.
Yeah. It also had Dumb and Dumber.
That was terrible. Except when there was poop everywhere. That was kind of funny. And when the guy from How I Met Your Mother said, "There's poop everywhere!" Everywhere. That was funny. Oh wait, which one of the Dumb and Dumber was I supposed to hold up? This one or this one?
Why did you have two?
I don't know. I got them both ready, I guess. Because we didn't say that he was in the mask, but we...
Yeah, he was in the mask, but
have
he didn't...
mask here.
Yeah, but,
we have it somewhere, but not here.
Yeah, not sure where that went. He didn't do the sequel to that one. That's the whole reason why The Mask 2 didn't happen. It's kind of strange.
There was a movie called
Son of the Mask?
Son Dumb of the Mask or something. But it didn't have Jim Carrey in it, and it looked terrible. I remember seeing the trailer when they first came it out for that thing, and I'm like... They waited like 100 years to put out a sequel to it, and and it looks like the special effects are even worse than in the first one. And
the effects are fine in the first one.
That's what I mean. The effects in the second one look worse than in the first one, even though it was made 11 years later.
Then why are you saying even worse? That means the effects in the first one were bad.
No, I'm saying the ones in the second one, you would expect that if they waited that long, at least the special effects would look good, but they don't. In the trailers, they look like crap, but I didn't see the movie itself. But I don't want to see the movie itself.
Yeah.
But we're not even talking about that right now. We're talking about this sequel.
Yeah, I found that it doesn't even mention have any mentions of the first Ace Ventura. It's kind of strange because, well, it came after, but he never even mentions, like, Flying Snowflake or anything to do with the first one. Jim Carrey's the only returning cast member from the movie. It's so weird.
Yeah, it's almost like maybe they were trying to do it like, I'm trying to think what's another movie series that does that, like James Bond or something like that, that where it's like it's just ongoing adventures of the character. Maybe, I don't know, maybe that was the plan. Maybe the plan was to make a whole bunch of different
adventures.
Or Indiana Jones, yeah, where it's different adventures and they don't necessarily have to bring up the events from the past. I don't know. But in any whatevers, I don't know, Garrett. I liked it, the first Ace movie. I didn't really like this one too much.
Yeah, in the first one, he had a reason to hurt the people. Because, like, they deserve to be hurt. You understood why he hurt them. But in this one, he had no reason to. Like, the Monopoly guy, he just hit him because he wanted to.
Yeah, he was kind of a jerk in this one, but in the first one he could be a jerk to people, but it was always people who were, like, you were glad to see them get beaten up or messed around or whatever, and it was more like, who is that old guy? That guy on the wall, what's his name?
Charlie Chaplin,
right. I think he did the same thing where it was like he always got people back, but it was always people who deserved it. But whereas in this one, he just like tries to be a jerk because it's funny. He did that sometimes in the first Ace movie.
Yeah, like when he made someone miss playing their mind window.
Yeah, but not so much. Not so much as in this one where it's like that's what he did most of the time. Whoops, sorry, I didn't mean to do that, Garrett. That was an accident. And it looked, I think it looked at, like, when I watched this movie, it didn't feel like it was supposed to be in the jungle or something. Mm-hmm. But to me, it seemed like it was all in, like, movie studios. Mm-hmm. It didn't even feel like the real jungle most of the time. And he fought with some Indians, and he played with himself with some Indians. I think he was master grading, because he was thinking of the Indian princess girl.
And she wasn't even that pretty.
And she wasn't even that good looking. I mean, I don't know.
At least in the first one, she was at least good looking. The girl in the movie.
And Courtney Cox, you're so hot. I like you on that show.
What show?
That's how the song goes, about Courtney Cox. And there's no mystery. That was the other thing. When I watched it, the first movie, I was like, oh, it was a neat little mystery he had to solve because he was a pet detective. But in this one, he was more of just a pet dickhead.
Well, I mean, there was the mystery of the bat. It just wasn't that good.
What was the mystery of the bat? I can't remember.
Like, someone took it and some scenes.
Oh yeah, the one evil person in the movie was the villain.
I mean, with the first one, it at least held your interest on this.
Yeah.
Cause like it was a big mystery and things kept happening and happening. In this one, it almost had nothing to do with that. Most of the time, it was just that. Just a jerk.
Yeah, it wasn't a very interesting story. I think the movie, when it was in the theaters, I think it made a lot of money because Jim Carrey was super famous back then. Mm-hmm. But it's not really a good movie. I don't think. What do you think?
I mean, it's definitely a good paced movie. I mean, the best part of it, without a doubt, is Jim Carrey's back as Ace Ventura. And doing some humor. Being funny as him.
Yeah, but I'm trying to think at some point where I actually thought it was funny.
I mean,
I guess when he got the two spears in his legs, that was kind of funny when he was like, ah, ah, ah. That was kind of funny.
Well, some scenes in the movie, I felt like it was, some scenes in the movie were basically just a recap of the first one. He used the same phrase, I'm a master of disguise, in this one. But the first one was so much funnier when he was pretending to be Melissa's brother.
Yeah.
The first one was so much funnier. Well, what made the first one funny, it's almost completely gone. I mean, one of the only parts I laughed was when he met him, he's like, oh, ha, 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 righty then. That's probably the only really funny part about it. He was talking from his butt and yodeling, and And he also did the oozy boo doo doo from the first one. But it's what made the first one funny is because it was unexpected. And he was a new character. But in this one, it was completely expected because we've already seen it.
Yeah, it was. I think the idea was maybe they thought that if. Because the character got so popular, they'd figure people would just want more of the same. And so a little bit of that is okay. But you're right, he didn't really offer anything new. They're like, when the first Ace Ventura came out, it's like, who is this guy? You never know quite what he's gonna do because he's so weird. But yeah, with this one, it's like, you're right, he didn't do anything particularly different.
Yeah, and some of the music that wasn't even theirs, they took it, that was from the first scene. For example, when the violins were playing in the scene where Ace Ventura is and Melissa are in that party or whatever it was, people with the violins, they used that again in the Monopoly Guy scene.
Did they?
Yeah.
Oh, I never noticed
that. And they also used that one song when Ace Ventura and Melissa were...
A wee dee 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 dee.
They used it twice.
A wee yum um away.
Yeah, but it's suited the first one.
Please tonight.
It suited the first one, but in this one they used it twice.
I thought, you know what, Garrett? I will debate you on this one because I don't remember when the second time was, but one of the times was when the bad guy got thrown to an ape or something like that, right? A horny ape?
Yeah.
And I thought that was pretty funny. Because you had to do was hear the music and you know that that guy was going to get some rough loving.
So yeah, I thought that was pretty funny. It showed a bush like moving around. And that was the same shot. And this scene was pointless. Like, it was like Spike finding like another monkey or something. And it used the exact same footage. And it had the exact same music. I don't know, it was just him seeing another animal. Hmm. So, I mean...
I will give it... Garrett, I don't think I can even give it a single wiener up. 0 out of 2 wieners up is what I have.
Okay.
Because it can't even get one of my wieners up.
Of course, the best part about...
Maybe half a wiener up, because there is one or two left. Half a wiener up. I'll give it a half wiener.
I mean, it was a disappointing sequel. Because Jim Carrey only did this because he doesn't like doing sequels. But what are you looking at?
I saw bigger, battier, and better. This movie is bigger and battier, but not better, because there's bats in it.
What?
Go on. What are you going to rank it?
I mean, of course, Jim Carrey is back as Ace Ventura is probably the best part, and, like, his humor, he still is trying to make you laugh, but... The direction and the editing, it just doesn't make it too much, that much funny. So, and the pacing was good. It was a fun movie, but most of it, some of it was just a recap, so I guess I'd give it a 6 or 7 out of 10. How about this? How about a 6.8 out of 10?
Wow, okay. But now let's watch something else, because I don't want to watch.
Want to watch the first one again?
Just watch it. Let's watch the new Batman and Robin commercial. Oh, bring it. This is your brand new kid. Bring it. Kitty?
Hey, why are you running away? Hey, come back here.